Avulum badge is giving me a yellow reading. Pecron concentrations there are low. Good work!
What a sinister plan to smoke the abbot out. As you remove the last of the kindling, the door opens and the abbot emerges.
Ah, thank you for your help. Harry, someone loyal to Avalon and the Great.
You might need some help with it. Thank you for your help. Are you somebody loyal to Avalon and the good Queen Gwendolyn?
You need to consult with the Lord of the Lake, Sacred Spylar Void, to restore a power. Return there when you've
The short of it is, defeat the foul skirkers, then destroy the kegs of effluent. Talk to the abbot when you're done.
My highest compliments.
My highest compliments. You are truly a servant of noble King Artorias. Additionally, you think you are finally beginning to understand the abbot.
Although the Lady of the Lake has been reduced, she's not without her allies. The Seraph Guardian of the Dolores Tower will attack anyone who comes. Get a branch from the olive tree and signal the Seraph from the shoreline. Tell me when you've done this.
You step up to the shore and wave the olive. The seraph sees you and raises her sword in salute.
You've made a friend. There's a signal horn hanging from a tree, now covered in chalk by goblin kudzu vines. You'll have to, once you see this.
You rip away the goblin. There is the signal horn. You reach the signal horn, and the sound is low and long. It announces you are here. The sound echoes around the shore. Long after you lower the horn, a path reveals itself, leading across the water.
bloody treacherous wizard! Oh, may you face a thousand deaths! Take this blasted iron key and be done with me!
You approach the Dolorous Tower. You feel the Seraph Guardian watching you closely. She gives you a hint of a smile, indicating you should enter the tower.
A glorious wizard and a knight of the weird, both in one. Truly, this is a portentous day. Of course I was expecting you, clever child. None other than an apprentice of Merle Ambrose could have freed me, or found Queen Gwendolyn, or defeated the Bane Worm. Come, gaze upon the Stele of Nicol and see what name is prophesied to us.
As you approach the floating Stele of Nicol, you feel an immense power and weight pushing down upon you. There is a hum of energy, and a swirl of mana, and a flash upon the stone.
Glorious, no? You have come to ask me about the Sword of Kings. I have returned it to... Do not fear. The Pendragon cannot draw it, for he is tainted. The sword waits until you are ready to face the Wild Hunt. Come, meet me outside this Tower of Sorrow. Two more knightly shrines you must visit before you will be deemed worthy of drawing the Sword of Kings. One is here, the other harder to reach. But first things first. We need to restore the shrine to mercy of a gentle rain from above upon the place beneath on both givers and takers. The stag chargers on the shore stole Mercy's shield, while the strangler goblins have Mercy's sword. Will you get them back?
Thank you.
fight as fiercely as King Artorius once did. Restore the shrine to Mercy. Your sharp eyes will see a portal appear leading. Do not fear. The portal will ensure you can breathe beneath the moon. I will meet you below to show you the path to the final shrine.
Restore the shrine to Mercy of a gentle rain from above. You hear the crash of waves and see a portal rising up to reveal the way below.
The Pendragon's foul magic even reaches under the lake's surface, this most sacred of places. He has done much harm to Avalon. The last shrine is located far beneath Castle Avalon. There is no way to reach it from above without facing the Pendragon. And he would kill you without the Sword of Kings. We will be sly and sneak you in from below. We must rebuild the broken teleporter arch. Defeat the Drowned Knight for the first piece of the teleporter arch.